All right, here we go, here we go. Bunch of Crunch Army, it's your boy. Back again, the one and only Keith Allen, your motivation guy. The one who roots for you, the one who encourages you to be the best person you can be. Not only playing Fortnite, but also in life. And so I want to just continue to feed your soul because you could do anything if you have confidence and you have faith in yourself, all right? Listen, I'm here to bring you guys the latest and greatest tips and tricks to help you guys become the best Fortnite player you could possibly be. So today, we're going to be talking about eagle eyes. Eagles are some of the most perceptive birds out there with the ability to spot creatures down below or far away as they fly from place to place, right? You know, as a competitive Fortnite player, you need to show the same level of skill in spotting enemies, spotting loot and activity as you rotate from one POI to the next. So, how do we achieve this level of skill? Let me tell you this. Well, we're here today to help you to do just that. But before we do that, man, it's time to get my favorite candy. Y'all need to help me say this out loud. Here we go. It's that Bunch of Crunch. Woo! And let's get this going. All right, so if you've ever been eliminated out of nowhere, then odds are that a player spotted you long before you died. If this is the case, then that means that you weren't paying attention to your surroundings or just left yourself exposed. Even if you weren't so careless, a vigilant player will be able to spot your movement or your building activity. Being vigilant, which means being aware, is one of the most important skills to have when playing any competitive game. Like, you've read your surroundings, but also pay attention to details that can be very, very far away or very close, which requires you to track movement quickly. And so there are many opportunities to scan the area and different strategies that you really need to keep in mind if you want to protect yourself from surprise attacks. Now, let's talk about the high ground. No, we're not talking specifically about retakes, but you know, we're going to talk about having a good vantage point where you can see everything happening from below you. Like, there are multiple ways to get the high ground, whether it be building a fort or just using your glider to scan the area. Essentially, whenever you're up in the air, you need to take the time to check your surroundings. Okay, so can you spot the players running around beneath you? What about loot? Training yourself to have an eagle eye really starts the moment you deploy your glider on the way down from the bus. Like, this is a skill you cannot perfect on creative, but rather, you're going to need to grind battle royale to really fully master. Truth is, guys, every player behaves differently, and while objectives sometimes overlap, they have different ways to deal with situations. And so this means two players may want to land on top of the same chest, and sometimes they're going to end up contesting the spot. And so meanwhile, in other situations, one player will simply decide to move on and try landing somewhere nearby. So whether or not that you're landing in a highly contested POI, you're going to need to keep track of what players are around you and, if possible, which chests spawn during this match. Gliding down is the perfect opportunity to see where players are headed and what kind of floor loot that they're going to have access to. This is especially important if you want to land at the Daily Bugle and get to those web slingers first. You got to keep a special eye out for those backpacks. All right, so with all this talk about spotting players, you also need to learn how to track them while aiming, man. So why not check out AimLab by clicking on the link below? Like, this program is going to allow you to perfect your aim so you can not only hit your target where it's going to hurt the most, but you can also keep hitting them consistently until you've taken home the elimination. With fully customizable courses, you are guaranteed to see improvement. So, don't let your opponents crawl away to safety, take them out. Redeploying works slightly different than the original drop. This time, you know, rather than just having multiple players just landing before or after you, most of the time, every player is going to be on the ground rotating. Also, any obvious chest is most likely already going to be looted, so you need to keep an eye out for any signs of just glowing yellow if you want a chance at upgrading your loadout during the mid-game. Redeploying can be useful for just spotting players fighting in the distance or even getting a good visual on your next destination. So this is going to give you guys a good heads up on what to expect when you get closer. Just remember, guys, to keep moving so you don't get shot out of the sky. Common ways of redeploying in Chapter 3 include using a launch pad trap so you can find as much as floor loot as possible, spending gold on characters or entering the rifts at the 7 bases. You can also use the vent near the statue of the foundation to get some airtime. On a side note, all right, you also want to make sure that your glider isn't too chunky. Umbrellas are the safest route to go due to their size. For a higher FOV, however, use the Sentinel from the Winterfest event. Alright, so this season we've seen the return of choppers. While this vehicle has been somewhat nerfed, it is still the best way to rotate from area to area. And so the best part about this vehicle is, you know, the major air time that you can get simply by just boosting at the right time and angle. Like, if you want to boost through the air and just really leave everything behind, then you want to build a ramp upwards and then just ride it until you feel that you can just boost off the ramp and onto the air. This is a common strategy used amongst people who want to get somewhere really fast, but it has another use as well. Okay, so when you're in the air, you can change seats and use your weapons. This allows you to scan the area below you, and if you're a highly trained shot, you can also use the moment to really take down other players using your sniper or the MK7AR. Okay, so this isn't the only tool that you have in your disposal this season to really get good air. Like, the Spider-Man web slingers are absolutely fantastic ways of rotating from one location to another. However, I will say this, there is more that you can be doing while swinging. So this is also perfect opportunity for you guys to really spot enemies and loot without leaving yourself too exposed. To do this, you're gonna need to train yourself to keep track of your objects passing by you. Sometimes you're gonna need to take advantage of settings and external equipment to really make yourself as aware as possible. One setting players are using is visual sound effects. In theory, this is the perfect way for players who are hard of hearing to have a visual representation of sound effects such as doors closing, reloading, and gunshots. Okay, so this system, however, has proven to be quite useful for pros such as Booga, who finds the system perfect for enhancing their awareness during a match. So make sure to keep this setting on so you can take advantage of it as well. Now, that doesn't mean that you can't play without sound, right? In fact, like, you should always try to play with the headphones when you can. And this is gonna prevent any outside sounds from distracting you as much as possible. Okay, so now for a bit on your setup. Don't forget to keep your play area as tidy as possible. All right, you gotta clean. Yes, talking to you, you have to be clean. Okay, that's a good thing. This means removing any unnecessary clutter from the tables. You can just freely move your mouse. This, in combination with a higher sensitivity, can allow you to do 360-degree spins much easier. As long as you can just grow accustomed to the senses, like, you can just start using these spins when rotating or during combat. Okay, so a quick 360 spin is important during any type of build battle. All right, so with these endless walls and roofs and floors being constructed at high speeds, I mean, it can be quite easy to lose track of your opponent's position, right? So you need to be able to catch those small details in between the cracks of enemy structures so you can just track their movements and just deny them the advantage of misdirection. Do this correctly and you're always going to know where your opponent is headed towards and which one of your walls they're going to try to strike at next. All right, so there are also some habits that you should consider conditioning yourself to perform, all right? All right, you guys gotta check this out. Snipers are the perfect weapon for long-range combat. You wanna be able to land that headshot so you can get a clear big chunk of their health in one go. And this is why you need to train your aim. However, players tend to use the snipers simply to just hit their target and engage in fights. You know, one overlooked use is that you can use the sniper to simply examine how far away objects are. Rather than just spotting an enemy and just engaging, hey, take a moment to scan the area. Like, is this player building? Are they engaged in a fight with another player? What kind of items are they using? This is a great way to analyze the situation before giving away your position, especially when there's always the possibility that, you know, they can fire back or block you using their building skills. All right, so another habit that you need to start developing is keeping an eye out for players who were just recently eliminated. While it may be hard sometimes to really spot players running across the screen when they're definitely far away from you, you know, they have one animation that will give away their final position. I'm of course talking about their death animations. Even if your opponent is in a building, like, you're gonna be able to see a shining blue light as they drop their loot. While this may mean that that particular player is no longer a target for elimination, you need to keep in mind that somebody else eliminated them just now and there's probably another player in that area. Best of all, you know, they're probably in need of a reload and some heals, making them a good target for you to go after next. All right guys, don't forget to check out Aim Lab while you're at it so you don't end up missing your shot. There you can get charts that reflect your gameplay and let you know exactly where you need to focus on to get that aim to 100%. Once again, guys, this is your motivation guy, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen, the one who is still believing in you each and every day. I'm not gonna lose my faith in you, so do not lose your faith in yourself. If you guys liked the video, make sure you guys subscribe to the channel and make sure to spread the word about what we got going on right here. Also, connect with me on my Instagram at your motivation guy. Also, feel free to leave a comment and just, you know, let us know what you'd be interested in learning more about, and we'll make that happen. All right, we'll see you on the next one. Peace.